knows a bit more about this than we do. How the statistics between Jorgen and Shami it looks.
Of course, it would be a fantastic evening for Jorgen to win
here in his hometown, Halmstad. Yeah,
hometown. So we see.
Halmstad will also be the host of the World Cup 2015 in October here. So we got a lot of fantastic table tennis coming up here in Halmstad the next few years. Jean Michel starts off the final very strong with a great forehand.
I think Jorgen is looking for a lot of backhand rallies. Blocking down to Xiaomi's backhand.
Yeah.
Keeping the ball deep to the backhand. But so far,
Xiaomi's backhand has been very strong so far this evening, I think.
He has improved his backhand side.
Very much so. Saive is in the lead 4-1 in the final of 2015 ITTF Legends Tour. Both players here have been really strong tonight, and you can tell that Saive is strong. He didn't play the quarterfinal. He got directly into the semifinals against Wallner, but he handled that task pretty well, I would say.
Yeah. He was ready when he played J.O. Good physically prepared and mentally prepared. So
what would you say will be the key here in this game, you think, for the one who win?
I think that Jorgen can find his backhand, playing well with his backhand, because then he can control Jomi, pushing him to run a lot. So he's the backhand game of Jorgen is a key for him.
Okay. We'll see how he can. 6-5. Close game so far. 7-5.
Very good to read the serve if the serve is half long. Jomi instinctively. His instinct is there. Very quick and attacking the ball.
Jean Michel Saive in the lead, 8-7. Persson to serve. He's really going for it here, Shami has said, and we'll see.
Some deep balls from Shami.
Yeah.
But Jorgen is down with his legs and top spinning it up. At all.
Oh. Very nice defense from Jorgen there. Got really frustrated. We can see here that the last time these two players met was 2007 in the Panasonic Open in China. And there, Jean Michel Saive won 4-3. Before that, they played 2004 in the World Team Table Tennis Championships in the men's teams group, and Jean Michel Saive won there as well, 3-1. And there he also took the first set, 11-8, against a very frustrated person, I think.
Was some rally there, Jorgen played very well, and he was not happy with the bounce of the ball, getting a little frustrated about that. But level of the game is good.
Yes. Both of the players are has an quite open style, so it's a lot of rallies. We can expect some more very nice rallies here. Persson deserves second set. Jean Michel Saive leads 1-0.
Jorgen coming around with his forehand in his backhand corner.
Probably we will see a bit more aggressive, aggressive person here, I think. Or at least I imagine we will see that.
Good start from Jorgen. Very a lot of energy, attacking all the time, playing good with his forehand. Jorgen started to serve in this set. He got some good balls to work with, so important for Jami to receive a little better here.
4-1, it's a good rally, good well played there by Saive, and now he's got the shorts folded up in his own characteristic way, which indicates that he's really pumped up, I would say. Important ball here now. Oh, very nice.
Short ball from Jorgen.
Yep.
Jorgen has been attacking a lot in this set, and John Mee defending, and have to run a lot. So even John Mee is looking a little tired.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic rally, fantastic rally.
Now Jean-Michel Saive is taking a break here, down at the LED screens, looking a bit tired.
But it's a very impressive rally between these two guys Of course in this age it takes a lot of energy.
Jean-Michel Saive is...
A long break from Jomi here, tactical.
46 years old and... Persson is 49. It's an amazing game, despite their age.
Touch of the net there.
6-3 for Jorgen, and Erik Lind said earlier in the interview that now you can see that the players are pumped up because the horns are coming out on their foreheads, but I would say that when Jorgen Persson is really up for it, you can tell by the look in his eyes.
Yeah.
He's got very much the eye of the tiger.
He's playing very well now, very well.
Very good point there, 7-3.
But But like we said before the game, it's a lot of open rallies between these two guys, and that's nice for the spectators, and it's nice to watch.
Yeah, very good game so far. Continues to play strong with his backhand, I think, Persson.
Vi vill uppmärksamma alla i publiken. Fotografier mer än välkommet. Med blixt, icke så gärna. Stäng av blixten om ni ska fotografera. Tack och förhand.
Tommy is helping the referee with the right score. So he's still in mentally in good shape.
8-4 Persson. There. Save is up on the table. Very nice forehands by Persson, I would say. A lot of power in them. Save is actually starting to look a little bit tired.
Yeah.
We'll see what that means for the future of this game. 10-4, Jorgen. Now we are probably looking at some exhibition games, balls. Oh. Save is out by the spectators, out of the playing field. Fantastic. Now they are going around the net, but there was a spectator in the way.
Yeah, it's amazing to see these guys and controlling the ball that perfect. Mm-hmm. I don't know, Jami, maybe he's leaving from the court now.
Yeah, he's on his way up to the
spectators.
Spectators, yeah. One one, very open game to come.
Yeah, and like you said in the end of this set, that Jean Mi looks a little tired, and he needs this break now to drink some water and rest and come back, because Jorgen is at the moment controlling the match.
Yeah.
But Jean-Mi, the signum from Jean-Mi is that he's a real fighter.
Yeah.
And I'm sure...
The Belgian Tiger.
Yeah, and I'm sure that he will come back here.
But Persson is looking really determined.
Yeah.
I don't think he wants to lose here in his own hometown of Halmstad, where he was born and raised. One zero, Jorgen. Got another issue with one of the balls here, probably.
Yeah, the ball broke during the rally.
So Save was asking Jorgen about the rules, and Jorgen said that I'm playing at home, so there should be no replay of that ball. But I don't know. And they're replaying that ball. So 0-0 again, level. And it's a nice rally, and Shami gets the first point of the third set. One all. And even our YouTube viewers noted that Shami looked a bit tired here, but now seems to be up and running again. Oh, very nice.
Fantastic. He's very close to the table, playing the ball in different direction and finishing with a smash.
Nice save there by Jorgen on the attack from Saive. Now he's in the lead, 3-2.
Also very impressive to see the players most of the time knowing where the players is hitting the ball, reading the game fantastically. This is something which I miss sometimes at today's player, the younger player today, the how to read the game and how to be in the right position most of the time. Today it's more of a power game. Than
the game has changed a lot.
Than the finesse. Mm-hmm. But these players are a very good example. In.
Can you say that this is the reason why they have been part of the world top players?
Yeah, for sure, for sure. So tactically very good and
technically also of course.
Yeah, technically of course.
And also as we saw they're developing their technique actually, because this was a stroke that Shami wasn't that strong. Wasn't one of his strongest strokes before. No. Now he had developed his backhand very much, I think. Seven-3 for Jean Michel Saive in the third set.
Also, Jean-Mi's strength is to win these, you know, simple points. Don't do any easy mistakes by himself. And like from here, from 3-3 to 7-3, four quick points. Not any spectacular rallies, but four quick win of the point and the points, 4 points in a row. So this is impressive by Jean-Mi.
Very much so.
Jorgen.
7-6. Jean Michel Saive to serve. Seven all.
Great comeback by Jorgen here. 3-7 to 7-7.
One of few unforced errors here by Shami with the forehand, I would say. Jorgen serve, 8-7.
He called.
The
home crowd is backing Jorgen up here in this critical situation of the match.
Yeah, we're facing a very important part of the game. Yeah,
spinning very good with his backhand on the first ball. A lot of spin in this ball. Jorgen cannot control.
9-8, save, serve. 9-8. Saive is relying more and more on his backhand serve now in this set. Yeah, so 9-0, Jorgen to serve. Really important part of the game now. Ooh. Nice save there by Shami. And we have set point, Jean Michel Saive. 10-9. Oh, net and out by Persson, and now Jean Michel Saive is one set away from winning the 2015 ITTF Legends Tour.
Jami receives deep to Jorgen's backhand, and it's very important for Jorgen to come down to get this good topspin on the first ball there. If he doesn't come down with his legs, with his body, difficult to make a good topspin there.
Mm-hmm. So we'll see what he can do to come back.
When he came out in the second set, he was very aggressive, trying to serve and start with his forehand and then pushing Jami back from the table. So if you have the power still, I think that's what he wants
so
to do.
So we will expect a more aggressive Jorgen Persson then. We'll see how that turns out here.
If you have the power.
If you have the power, the ping pong power. So if you just tune in, you're watching the 2015 ITTF Legends Tour, and we have reached the finals, and we have in the court Jorgen Persson and Jean Michel Saive, and Jean Michel Saive leads now 2-1, and Persson to serve in the fourth set. Backhand spin.
It's more. If he comes down, and get more. Even more rotation in the ball, and that's good. Focusing more on the spin than the speed.
But as you said before, Tikan, that Saive is not giving away any easy points, and Jorgen has to work really hard for every point.
Yeah, that's what it takes to beat Xiaomi.
Also had a lucky ball there and touched the edge. Nice rally there, and Jorgen was the winner of that one.
I really like to see when he's defending from the back of the court that he's putting this topspin on the ball, and also he have a great length of the ball, so it's very difficult to come through him. And this is something I like with these players, you know. Even if they are pushed back from the table, they can defend very well.
Yeah, they can defend themselves very well. We can also say that almost all of these players are technically complete.
Yeah.
They have very few weak points. 2 edge points now from Saive in this set.
Yeah. I don't know if Jorgen is taking a timeout or. But a little unlucky start for Jorgen in this set. Pushing Jami on the attack side, but 2 unlucky points for Jorgen.
Interesting thing is that both players now are relying on the backhand serve, which is a bit rare.
Yeah,
in today's table tennis, actually.
But this is two of not so many players who have very good backhand serve also. Vladimir Samsonov is another one. And I think it's important tactically in games when you feel that you have lost some momentum, that you can change and use another tactic.
Yeah, also one of their strengths, I think. The ability to change tactic in the middle of the game and to analyze and do corrections in the tactics. Ooh. Very close. Hit the backhand just outside. After a very, very nice deep chop.
I think we're watching a very nice final. Yep. Very nice final. Unbelievable nice rallies.
Yes.
Between two
The crowd seems to enjoy. And
yeah, they must do. Good chance for Jorgen there.
He's been a bit unlucky in this fourth set, actually. Saive has got two edge balls, and Persson has got a couple of nets out. So. Maybe now it's time for the timeout, or no? Probably also Shami wants to show the other guys that he is still active. He plays on the tour, so he doesn't want to give anything away here. So maybe it's a bit like, hey guys, I'm still active, so I'll show you who's the boss.
Jorgen tried a straight serve. Quick long serve, but Xiaomi is moving very well. Moving now, timeout's coming. It's very nice to see Xiaomi moving that good at his age.
Jorgen now has taken a timeout.
Yeah.
We'll see if that will help him. But he is in a very tricky position right now.
Yeah.
And what would you say will be? Is there anything that he can do? You think more aggressive or?
No, I mean he keep on playing. I mean this set he has been playing very well, but what has been a little unlucky.
Yeah.
Important now is not to get negative. Still believe in winning this match.
3 points away from winning the Legends Tour for Jean Michel Saive. Now only 2 points.
Good receive by Jean Michel.
Very good
short receive. Comes the backhand serve again.
And there we're at 4 match points for Jean Michel Saive. Will be very difficult for Jorgen to turn this match around, I would say. Well, he saved one of the four, so 7-10. Jorgen is back in the court, playing high balls. Ah, there we have a winner. Jean Michel Saive is the winner of the 2015 ITTF Legends Tour.
Well-deserved winner, I think.
Very nice
final. Very nice final between two very good players. Amazing to be playing that well in that age.
So was the best player that won, do you think?
Yeah,
tonight?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. He beat both Waldner and Persson.
Yeah.
And both
John Ove and Jorgen forced him to play at his best and had a good chance. But like we said before, he's a fighter and he's coming back when it looks bad for him or difficult for him. He's coming back.
Can
so
we say that
the winner?
Yeah, very worthy winner. But can we say that Waldner was perhaps closer to win against him, or
I think also Jorgen had a good chance. In the third set, he had some good possibilities to win the set. In the first set, he had some good possibilities to win the set.
Okay.
So, but both the Swedish guys put up a very good fight against Jomi.
Well.